Intern, there you are! I swear, I just saw it! I just saw it hop past my foot! A full-grown bullfrog! Isn't that so exciting? Oh, and hello! Hello, little mallard! How are you doing today? Whoops! Apparently one of the catfish isn't doing too well. On land, eh? Let's get you back in the water there, lovely lady. Uh-oh, and the catfish is sick! Okay, hang on, intern. We're gonna need to hop in here and make sure that our fine animals are doing alright. Let's see. It's a beautiful, absolutely amazing catfish pond, if you ask me. Perfect for plenty of places for them to swim around, to eat lots of different things. These guys are swimming side by side. There we go. Oh, look at them. I wonder if they're making some little catfish babies right now. We'll have to find out. Good. look. It's our alligator snapping turtle. Oh, look at it. Did you know the alligator snapping turtles spend most of their life in the water? The only time you really see alligator snapping turtles on land, if they're not hunting for food, is when the females are going to lay their eggs up on the land. Oh my gosh. It looks like such an elegant creature in the water, doesn't it? And look at those roots. I love seeing the roots and the fallen trees and the cattails and just the formations and the random weird land formations. That's kind of awesome, actually. On all of the little krill and the little plants and animals that make up the whole delicate ecosystem of this lake. I absolutely love it. And also, we've got some very hungry little mallards roaming about. So we're normally, you know, you want to get out of the way and kind of let nature take its course, but we are still trying to get this delicate ecosystem established. So let's go ahead, put down some branches, encourage some insects to maybe take root. So that we won't lose any of the wee little baby mallards. And that'll actually be a good thing to get more plants and insects involved, because hopefully, in turn, that'll mean that we will see even more increase in biodiversity here in the absolutely amazing, fantastic Beaver Lodge Park. And we have been doing so great lately. In fact, I have a letter right here from the BLB. Let me just, sorry, I gotta help tidy some things up. How is everybody doing over here? My gosh, look at all those. Intern, I told you I saw the frog. Look at it. Look at it. It's the North American bullfrog. Oh, it climbed under this log, but I just saw it hopping over here. Oh, there it is again. Ah, there it goes. Oh my gosh, I could just be a herpetologist and chase this frog down all day long. It is just, look at it. Oh, it's going to jump on my foot. Oh, you're so cute. Ah, and there he goes, disappearing off into the little creek bed. Oh, that's just so much fun, so much fun. But yes, let me go ahead and whip out the awesome letter that I happen to have here from the BLB. Oh dear, and we've got more hungry babies. More hungry babies, but you know what? The mallards are going to have to figure it out for just a minute. All right, let's see what we got here. Dear Zookeeper Siri, thank you so much for all of your hard work in our park. The wetlands are absolutely thriving, and we couldn't be more thrilled with the biodiversity that has emerged from this once empty land. News of a fox arriving into the territory is absolutely wonderful. We had hoped to introduce our native foxes back into the area, but to know that a male has moved into the territory on his own is tremendously helpful. In accordance with our agreement with the local zoo, we have been offered a female to keep in the park for conservation and breeding purposes. We are very interested to see if we can release this female into the park proper to see if the wandering male would be interested in her as a mate. If so, this could give us a wonderful boost to this genetic line. Once the fox is pregnant, we can move her safely into the enclosed fox exhibit, where we can continue caring for her and her pups to keep the unique genetics of the local foxes safe. They are still heavily hunted in this area, so leaving her wild would not be safe. But capturing the male may upset the delicate balance we have established as well. However, the zoo will not release the female to us until her exhibit is properly built. Could you help us finish the fox exhibit? Sincerely, the Beaver Lodge Beaver Conservation Society. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Oop. Time to refill that grass. Oh my gosh, look! Look at the wee little baby! Look at the wee little baby beaver! And we have had so many baby beavers born lately, intern. And look at that view with that beautiful duck in the background. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And look at the little itty bitty baby duck. Oh my goodness. Yes, I am very excited that the Beaver Lodge Beaver Conservation Society is so happy with the work that we have done here, because it is just transforming this landscape, and you can look out and just see the wilderness from here. It is wonderful. It is wonderful, and the only thing I really wish is that we could just keep some of the tadpoles thriving. I think they've got a fungal infection, which is unfortunately very common among frogs right now. Why are you very sick? Where are you? Okay, hang on. We're trying to combat this horrible fungal infection among the tadpoles, because we need them. We need them healthy and strong. Very healthy and strong. I think most of them have been eaten, actually. I'm not seeing a lot of them. Aw, dang it. And it just died of illness. Great. Just great. There's a tadpole. Live! Grow! I know that the longer a tadpole stays a tadpole, the bigger the frog, but we don't need mammoth-sized frogs, please. My goodness. So we'll have to keep an eye on those guys and make sure they're all right. Look. I love watching the beavers swim across the lake. Isn't it just the best thing? Zoom in. Look at that. Oh, what a beautiful sight. And we have helped create this too. I mean, just look at this. We've helped build this, intern. Isn't that fantastic? Oh my gosh, it is just fantastic. Ah, of course, there's still more work to do. We need to add in quite a few more plants in various areas. I haven't seen the fox for a little while. The animals don't really come over to this side of the forest, and I don't really blame them. We've got a lot of trees, but no undercover, not a lot of growth for down here. So what we're going to try to do is we're going to try to bring over some of the underbrush. You can see how over here, where we tend to find a lot of the animals, there's a lot more variety in the fact that there's underbrush on the ground, lots of bilberries, lots of lilies, things like that. So we're going to try to add in more of that, more ferns, maybe put up some more rock piles, because those make wonderful dens for the various animals. And speaking of dens for the various animals, let's work our way over to where we need to work on the fox exhibit. Now, it would be wonderful if we could just keep the fox wild inside of the park proper all the time. It's so wet down here. So many leeches. So much noise! You know what? No. Out of here. Get out of here. Yeah, you guys are gonna have to listen to the beautiful song of bird song instead, or put on the little headphones. Oh, what is his problem? Not entertained and amused enough. Well, you know what, sir? You know what? He's probably gonna go on his little, oh my gosh, look at that! People are just throwing their trash on the ground again. That's not how we do these things. Here you go, here is a trash can, use it. Look, she just threw her trash in the same spot! And you know what happens? Then we get bad ratings because these people have no common decency. It's always so frustrating when that happens in turn. So we're going to try to work around their fussiness, because if we don't at least attend, even though this is a non-profit park, if we don't attend to the guest needs, then they go home and they complain about it on their little Twitters and their blogs, and then we lose federal funding because we don't have high ratings. So unfortunately, we do need to pay attention to this somewhat. Let's see. Mallard 12, what you doing? Oh, you're a big one, too. All right, let's put down some more water bowls, see if that helps out. There we go. But yes, so we do have to attend to the visitors somewhat because it is important. I shouldn't be so hard on them. It is very important that we help them by educating the general public. So let's go ahead. Here you guys go. Have a fountain. I hope this helps things. We'll put a matching fountain over on this side. There you go. And then for some reason, even though this is a non-profit society, dang it, we lost a mallard to illness. That does happen from time to time. It is the cycle of life. It truly is. But these guys are complaining. We are a non-profit, so it doesn't cost them anything to get in here. But it does cost them money to buy ice cream. So if they want some ice cream, they're going to have to come to an ATM. And if they want to go to an ATM, we will put one right there for them. We'll put a little ATM right here. Carol the second. Oh yes, and we do have a dislikes being in such a smelly exhibit. You know what? Actually, we can hire more park rangers. So I think we're gonna do that. Since so many new babies have been born, we had, let's see, 5 new babies born. Already have, so we can hire 2 more park rangers. So welcome to Park Ranger Rick. And welcome to Park Ranger, let's see, Victor. There we go. And they should help out quite a bit over here. I love it. I know I complain about being busy sometimes, but I really love keeping busy in turn. That is why we're good at these kinds of jobs. All right, so let's go ahead and get this ATM in here. And then the guests can come over here so they can... Here, sir. You're getting a drink from our drinking fountain that we have. He's headed straight to that ATM, so there you go. Hopefully that'll help. How's our little gift cart doing? Absolutely no one has bought anything from this gift cart. That's a problem. I wonder if he's just in the wrong spot. Should we try moving him? Were you just being blocked, sir? Was that the problem? Drinking fountain, ice cream, few animals, leaving the park, waiting in line. Huh. Maybe if we put them, maybe people don't want cheap stuff, so we'll try that and see what happens. Huh. Well, we'll keep an eye on that in turn. We'll keep an eye on that. And then the next thing we actually need to do is get started at making this area. This is where the female fox is going to be kept. Unfortunately, she cannot be kept in the wild, as I said, because there's not enough of a stable population to be able to risk losing her valuable genetics. But we will be able to keep her tagged and collared and keep a close eye on her in the park proper. So hopefully she will find the male that is roaming around, mate with him, and then as soon as we get the little GPS information alerting us that her hormones have changed and it is time for her to have pups, we will put her in here. But to even be able to get her in the first place, we need to transform this amazing exhibit into, well, an amazing exhibit. It's not an amazing exhibit right now, in turn. It's kind of just a bare, empty patch of land. So, I need you to go check on those mallards really quickly, and I'm going to spruce this place up real fast, and then we'll see if we can make it a nice, proper area suiting of a female fox. So, just go check those mallards, and we'll be back over here. I'm just going to put some leeches and some water in here, and I'll see you guys in just a second. Intern, there you are. So, tell me, how are the mallards doing? So that's the case, huh? Well, it sounds like if the mallards are starting to disappear a little bit with the baby ducklings, as sad as that is, that does mean that we are getting a healthy established ecosystem. Speaking of healthy established ecosystem, no whales catch fish. Why are you? Oh, it's stuck. It's stuck in the little waterfall, but we've got it. There you go, little one. There you go. Is that better? Well, I guess that little one is not really the right word to describe our whale's catfish, but I think it's going to be okay now that we have it here back in its water. Oh my gosh, and it's so beautiful in here. Just look at how gorgeous all of this is. Oh, absolutely lovely, absolutely lovely. But we are working on a wonderful, lovely part of the park. And look at these ferns. Oh my goodness, I love these ferns. These lady ferns are just so beautiful. Oh, and intern, I am just so proud. I can't believe we've completed so much, and to know that soon, the Beaver Lodge Beaver Park is going to be able to support a healthy native population of red fox again, and oh my goodness, that's a good thing, though. Foxes, they're not really threatened, but this happens to be a genetic subspecies that they want to see stay healthy and alert. But as you can see, intern, I have added in quite a few amazing new trees. Well, personally, I think these trees are amazing. We've got some maples, some elders, and I think a couple birch scattered in here as well. I thought I had a fir, but I don't see it. Then we've also got some of these beautiful lady ferns, and we've got some of the lovely bilberries. And then right over here, you can see where we've got a really nice little cave, a little burrow for the fox to hopefully enjoy, kind of tucked in the back here, away from the prying eyes of the park guests, so hopefully she'll feel nice and secure over here. Hopefully that'll help her out, but we have to think about what else our lovely fox would want in her area. Because this is going to be, unfortunately, unfortunately, she is going to be a monitored animal. Other than releasing her into the main park so that hopefully she can find her mate and become pregnant, we are keeping her separated from the wild and keeping an eye on her in a more contained area. So we want to make sure that we give her as many opportunities for enrichment and a varied diet and health as possible. And something is going on with mallard number 14. Going to drink from the water dish. Sometimes these little baby mallards have some trouble, so let's pluck this little one up. My goodness, where the heck had it even wandered off to? No wonder. It's wandered way away from where most of the ducks tend to be. There we go. And actually, Intern, our park ranger suggested that just to help the mallards kind of have somewhere safe to go and to rest, we have added in a few shade structures, which aren't really, you think that the trees would be enough shade, but sometimes it's not. So the ducks actually really seem to be taking to these little shade structures. I wish they looked like trees, but for now, this is definitely going to do to kind of protect them and keep them a little happier. What you doing over here, duck ducks? Because that is still our goal. This is a unique mixture of wild and public territory. So we will be mixing in a few things that you wouldn't find in the wild, but that's okay. That's okay. Like giving our wonderful fox, as I was saying, a nice varied diet, lots of things to play on, lots of things to keep her busy and entertained. So let's see what we've got here. Let's see. Well, she is definitely an eater of ducklings, so we will kind of plant a few ducklings around here. That's just the natural result of being in an area with a very healthy and ever-growing mallard population, to be honest. And then we want to make sure that she's got things to keep her entertained. So actually, these bones, which some of them are donated from hunters and from local cow farms, these bones are an excellent way for her to have something to chew on. We'll throw in a couple of the frogs from our pond just to give her something to chase. And you know, the frogs have an opportunity to hide under the rocks and get away too. So that's just kind of the cycle of nature right there. She does have her little burrow home that I think she's gonna enjoy. And then I think all we really need to work on now, Intern, is kind of sprucing up the rest of her exhibit to make sure that she's got just a nice variety of plants and things to eat. Foxes are primarily, they eat meat, and they're very good opportunistic hunters. Anything that they can get their mouths on, they're gonna chew up and eat, but they do enjoy, ooh, look at this red top grass. It's so pretty. Ooh, and the Wells catfish is now pregnant. Wonderful, I love catfish babies. They're just so adorable with the little fat faces. Oh, so cute. But yes, so, as I was saying, cough cough, back to being a serious biologist. The red foxes, ooh, no, we don't want to put stinging nettle in here. That's not what I was thinking of for the poor thing. They are kind of omnivores. They'll chew on fruits and berries and things like that. So it's not uncommon to find that they've raided a nice berry bush somewhere. So we want to give her a little bit of variety there. Ooh, look at that June grass. Yay, the Wells catfish has laid some eggs. Wonderful, wonderful. All right, let's get some June grass over here too, I think. To kind of hide the bones, you know? So she can curl up and she can be like, nom, 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 nom. These are my bones. I'm gonna chew on them. Good. And then the flowers are more for the guests, to be honest. You know, and to give her something different to smell, to sniff, to investigate, you wanna try to throw in some random things that just make the animals curiosity. Curiosity might be a strong word, that make the animals feel more engaged, safely engaged, not stressed engaged, but safely engaged with their environment and territory. And we're going to add in a few of these lady ferns. In fact, we're going to put quite a few of them up against the border here so that there's a bit of a visual gap between where the guests are going to be walking and where our red fox is, so that she doesn't have that stress of constantly seeing all the people's legs move and all the little kids peer through there, which means the guests are going to have to peer pretty carefully in here to be able to see her through the ferns along the fencing. But that's healthier for her, and she is our main priority here. There we go. Yay, the ratings on the Twitters are getting a little more popular. We probably do need to do a little bit more work with those guesties. Make sure that they're happy so that they come and support their national parks more often. So we'll do that in just a bit. Let's get more bilberries sprinkled around. And I think we'll put in some nice cheese. There goes the little toad. Hop, little toad, hop! Here's some ground cover for you, little toad, to try to give you somewhere to hide. Hopefully that'll help. And let's go ahead and add in a few rocks. Little rock. Ooh. I like the shape of these rocks, Intern. I bet you didn't think that you'd be spending your days judging the size and shape of rocks one day, eh? Alright, let's go for something a little bit smaller. There we go. There, but you know, rocks are an important part of the ecosystem too. They give things places to hide. Ooh! Ooh, wonderful! We've got a bronze commemorative seal because it has been a year of working here, intern. Can you believe that? We've been together for years and years now. It's been rather amazing, actually, and I hope you're learning a lot. One day you will be a zookeeper in your own right, and no longer my intern, so that's gonna be pretty darn amazing. Alright, let's see. I'm gonna put this right here. Oh no, the catfish is beached again. Why? Get back over here, my dear. Huh. Maybe if we put some treats in here for the catfish. Something for them to pursue and chase. Let's see, let's grab some burbots. Let's throw in a couple, 3 burbots, 1 for each catfish. And maybe that'll help them stay a little more focused. And look, the catfish eggs! Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Alright, and then I think the only thing missing from her lovely exhibit over here, her lovely future home, which hopefully we can move her to. We are going to keep the GPS tracker on her long enough to see if she can become pregnant. We'll add in some water dishes. I kind of want to add in a little creek too. Kind of really do. So, yeah, I might put a teensy little itty bitty creek right over here. Here we go. Little tiny baby creek. No, I want the nice pretty. There. There we go. So just a teensy tiny little baby creek. Good. No, help! Alright, intern, we very, very gently want to put some grass along the edges there. There, that's good. And then let's grab some of the cattails. We've got plenty of cattails. And I've been seeing a little bit more flooding spreading now that the beavers are getting so big, so we'll have to keep an eye on that too. There we go. Beautiful. Just utterly beautiful. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Alright. Look at this. Nice thick ferns for her to crawl through, bones for her to chew on, flowers for her to sniff and have a little bit of that variety. In fact, we'll add... No, you know what? I think this is good, intern. I think this is good. Alright, so let's contact the zoo, and then in the morning, hopefully they will deliver the female fox. We can release her to the main bulk of the park, and then hopefully, oh yay, we have more catfish babies, yay, the BLB are going to be so happy to hear that. And then hopefully in the morning, we will be able to release her into the wild, and we'll see some very interesting things spreading in the main park. So I will see you in the morning, intern. Bye-bye.